What's going on, everybody? Tommy from Fight Camp here, and in this video, I'm going to be breaking down how you throw an uppercut on a vertically shaped heavy bag. So this video is perfect for you if you're just starting out learning how to box, you're trying to learn how to box from home, or if you just need a little bit more polishing on throwing those uppercuts on the heavy bag. So before you get started, take some time, let me know in the comment section below where you currently are in your boxing journey. Is there anything that's currently frustrating you that we can help with? Let us know in the comment section below. Okay, so let's get into this. So when we teach you to throw your uppercut, obviously you start from that neutral stance and you're taught to sit down nice and low. You bring that hand off of your face at a 90 degree angle. You turn your hips and you scoop the punch up vertically. So that's the rear uppercut right there. The lead uppercut looks like this when you're shadow boxing, when you're hitting the mitts, or when you're hitting an opponent. But when you're hitting a vertical bag, it's a little bit more difficult to wrap your head around how to land that punch to the head. It creates a little bit more difficulty with the vertical bags. All right, so I'm gonna take some time right now to demonstrate how to properly throw the uppercuts to the head on a vertical traditional heavy bag. Okay, so throwing uppercuts to the body on a traditional heavy bag is not too challenging. This is what it looks like right here. You sit down in your stance, very close range stance, not a long range stance like you would if you were throwing a jab and longer range punches. You sit very close, like you're on the inside. You drop your hand if you're gonna throw that rear uppercut, and you drive the punch directly through your hips, just like that. And you land it about body level on the bag. So you wanna line up on the bag whenever you hit the bag and sort of like scope out where an opponent your size would be. So the head level will match with your head level and the body level of your opponent will match with your own body level. So when you throw that rear uppercut, you wanna make sure that you open this up at a 90 degree angle, you turn your foot, you twist your hips, and you drive the uppercut directly through the bag just like that. Here's what the lead uppercut to the body looks like on the bag. Just like that. Rear uppercut, lead uppercut. One more time, rear uppercut, lead uppercut. All right, so now when you take that uppercut and you bring it up to the head, it gets a little bit more challenging on a traditional heavy bag. And I'm gonna show you how to do that right now. Let's say that we're leading with a combination that leads off a jab, and then you're gonna come with that rear uppercut. The way I'd like to see that land on the bag is just like this. So you throw that lead jab, make sure you're sitting down, you're nice and comfortable in your stance. As you're bringing that lead jab back to your face, you open that rear uppercut up just like this, and you land it on the bag head level at this angle just like that. So let me show you how that looks in real time. I got that jab, rear uppercut. Jab, rear uppercut, just like that. Now on the lead side, I want it to look exactly the same. Obviously you want to make sure that you're transferring your weight before throwing a lead uppercut, so it would usually come off a rear-handed punch. So I'm gonna throw a cross and then a lead uppercut, and it's gonna land just like that. So again, this is what the lead uppercut should look like on the bag. There's the cross, there's the lead uppercut. Cross, lead uppercut, just like that. Now let's put it together with some different combinations. So I'm gonna throw a jab, rear uppercut, hook, rear uppercut. Again, jab, rear uppercut, hook, rear uppercut. I'm gonna throw a cross, lead uppercut, cross, hook. Let me throw that again. Cross, lead uppercut, cross, and hook, just like that. Okay, so one of the big myths with the uppercut is that it's just this like big power punch that you'll throw to finish somebody off at the end of a fight. That couldn't be further from the truth. Uppercuts are very useful in longer combinations, and they're really useful as short range setup punches too. So make sure that you learn how to throw that uppercut from a long range so that you can have power, but also practice on throwing that uppercut from a short range so that you can set up greater combinations. Remember, you start from that neutral stance, and all the power comes from generating all that force directly through your hips and not from scooping that uppercut from the floor. So you're in your stance, you sit down, you open that hand up, you drive it up through your hips. And the way that should look on the heavy bag is just like this. You sit down, that's to the body, that's to the head. Here is the lead hand to the body, lead hand to the head. All right, remember, we're just starting out. We're new to this, and we're not gonna master this overnight. So I want us to take our time, and practice very slowly and very deliberately this uppercut motion in front of the mirror. I want you to have that mental model of what it's supposed to look like on that bag, and I want you to strive for that with your own motions. Okay, thanks for watching this video on the uppercut. I hope you enjoyed it. Until next time.